on today's news?
I mean, at this point, you know, in the league, you've seen almost everything. So it's not much that actually shocks you. But, you know, it's part of the game. It's part of the business.
Why would y'all lose, you know, losing the guy again?
I mean, he's a phenomenal player. Been a phenomenal part of what we've done. And, you know, good players in this league, you know, hard to come by, but it's a next man up business. It's just part of the game.
Would you say you're disappointed by this?
What do you mean by that? What do you
think? I'm just reading your body language. You just seem like you're disappointed that he's not here.
Yeah, I mean, it's a tough day, right? You know, not just with that, but they got to cut the roster down to 53 guys, and so though it's a business, and you understand that, but it's still relationships, and it's not like you lose those relationships. They, you know, they go different places, and you stay in touch and whatnot. But it changes the dynamic of your locker room when guys that were once there and then are not there. So that's just the reality of what we deal with on a regular basis, and. You know, it's just not our team. Every team is dealing with that. So it's nothing unique, but I mean, being a human being, you have emotions when somebody's beside you and then all of a sudden they're not.
What's your message to those guys as the leader of this team, guys who are
on? Control what you can control. At the end of the day, all we can do is control what we can control, and that's our energy, our attitude, our body language every single day, our effort. And that's what hopefully everybody's given up to this point. And hopefully they'll continue to do that, whether they're a part of this team or they go to another team, or if they played their last NFL snap, that they'll continue that in life. And that's all you can do is at the end of the day, you can control the controllables, and the controllables are yourself. You can't control what decisions are made that are outside of you. So. That's kind of my message to just in life in general.
How much confidence do you guys have in Bradley Roby and what he's been able to do over the last year with this defense?
I got confidence in everybody in this locker room to do their job. We have phenomenal players at all levels, especially on our defense. And, you know, in our secondary, there's so many guys back there. Same up front. And same at linebacker. And so I trust our organization and the decisions that they make. The guys that's out there, they're going to be able to get the job done.
With that amount of trust around this defense, I know we see more and more nickel packages across the NFL, but a three linebacker set, is that something that this team could still be successful with on the defensive side?
We do both. Mm-hmm. We have three linebackers out there. Two linebackers is really – about matching the offense. Sometimes they run packages or formations that don't allow you to have three linebackers out there, and so you have to match up. But we do both. We do three and two. I think most teams, it's about the same.
When it comes to being a vocal leader in the locker room, when you're losing such a distinct voice, yeah, how do you go about kind of filling that void to make sure that there's that communication, that kind of leadership still exists?
The game is easy. The game is the game. It's a next man up business. It's the NFL. And so you lose good players all the time. I mean, some Hall of Fame players were on a team and then they weren't. And so how do you replace a void like that? We've had to do that here at quarterback, losing, you know, one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time. So the game goes on. That's the easy part. The life part is what's challenging. You know, you develop great relationships with individuals, and they're close to you. And I guess the fortunate part of it is life is that they're just moving to a different location. But just not being able to see that person every day, being able to laugh and hang out and chat with somebody that was a comrade that was right beside you. So I think those emotions don't go away. Imagine being in high school and having your buddies, and then your parents come tell you that you're moving, and now you have to go. right? And you know, you experience that on both sides. You the kids experience the hurt because they're not able to go hang with their friends. That's the first thing they think about. And then the parents have to deal with the dynamics of moving, getting adjusted, and that's what players and families have to go through that no one sees. Everybody sees the game, but they don't see what's going on in life behind that. Like, you have to sell your house, you have to move your stuff, you have to find new schools for your kids, you have to build new relationships. And so every dynamic that someone else has going on in life, that's what we have going on. And so the game is easy. It's the life part that's challenging.